ओम शांति। दिस इज़ द साकार मुरली ऑफ 10th of June 2024। एसेंस, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, कॉन्स्टेंटली कीप योर एम इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड यू विल कंटिन्यू टू डेवलप डिवाइन वर्च्यूज। यू नाउ हैव टू लुक आफ्टर योर सेल्व्स, रिमूव डेवलस्ट ट्रेट्स एंड इम्बाइव डिवाइन वर्च्यूज। Question, even though you have received the blessing of having a long life, what effort do you have to make to have a long life? Answer, in order to have a long life, make effort to become Sato Pradhan from Tamo Pradhan. The more you remember the father, the more Sato Pradhan you will become. Your life spans will increase and the fear of death will be removed. By having remembrance, your sorrow will be removed and you will become flowers. It is by having remembrance that you earn an incognito income. By having remembrance, your sins are cut away. Your souls become light and your life spans become long. Om Shanti. The Father explains and teaches you, sweetest spiritual children. What does He explain? Sweet children, firstly you should have long life spans because your life spans were very long. You had life spans of about 150 years. How do you receive a long life span? By becoming Sato Pradhan from Tamo Pradhan. When you were Sato Pradhan, your life spans were very long. You are now climbing up. You know that your life spans became short because you became Tamo Pradhan. You didn't have good health either. You became completely diseased. This is an old life and it is compared with the new life. You know that the Father is now showing you the way to have a long life span. Sweetest children, if you remember me, you will once again become like you were. Sato Pradhan and healthy with long life spans. When you have a short life span, there is the fear of dying. You have a guarantee that you will never experience untimely death in the golden age. If you continue to remember the Father, your life spans will be long and all your sorrow will be removed. You won't experience any type of sorrow. What else do you want? You say that you also want a high status. You didn't know that you could receive such a status. The Father is now showing you the way to do this. Your aim and objective in front of you. You can claim such a status. You have to imbibe divine virtues here. Ask yourself, do I have any defects in me? There are many types of defects. To smoke and eat dirty food are also defects. The biggest defect is that of vice, and that is also called having a bad character. The Father says you have become vicious and I am now showing you the way to become viceless. In this you have to renounce vices and defects. You must never become vicious. The reincarnation of those who reform themselves in this birth will last for 21 births. It is most essential for you to become viceless. Only with your power of yoga will the burden of many births that you have on your hands be removed. You children know that you have been vicious for birth after birth. You now promise the Father that you will never become vicious again. The Father has said, if you become impure, you will have to experience 100-fold punishment and your status will also be destroyed. This is because you defamed the Father, which means that you went over to the other side, brackets to worldly human being. Many live in this way, that is, they are defeated. Previously, you didn't know that you should carry out that business of vice. Some children who are good say that they will remain celibate. When they see the sannyasis, they think that purity is good. There are impure beings and pure beings. Many people in the world are impure. even to go to the laboratory is to become impure, and this is why you should shower straight away. There are many types of impurity. To cause someone sorrow, to fight and quarrel are also impure acts. The father says you have been committing sin for birth after birth. You now have to finish all those habits. You now have to become truly great souls. It is only Lakshmi and Narayan who are truly great souls. No one else can become that here because all are tamo pradhan. They cause a lot of deformation. They don't know what they are doing. One is an incognito sin and other is a sin committed visibly. This is a tamo pradhan world. You children know that the father is now making you sensible, and this is why you all remember him. You receive the best understanding, which is that you have to become pure. But you then also need to have virtues. You now have to become similar to the praise of the deities that you have been singing. The father explains, sweetest children, you were such sweet and beautiful flowers, and you have now become thorns. Now remember the father, and through that remembrance your life spans will become long and your sins will also be burnt away. The burden will be removed from your heads. You have to look after yourselves. You have to remove the defects that you have in you. Similarly, there is the example of Narad. He was asked, "Are you worthy?" He saw that he was truly not worthy. The father is now making you elevated. You are the children of the father. When someone's father is an emperor, he would say, "My father is the emperor." Baba is the one who gives you a lot of happiness. Those who are emperors with good natures never get angry. Now everyone's degrees have gradually decreased. They have become influenced by all the defects, and their degrees have continued to decrease. They have continued to become tamo. It is as though it is now the end of the tamo pradhan stage. They have become so unhappy. You have to tolerate so much. You are now being treated by the eternal surgeon. The father says those five vices will repeatedly harass you. The more effort you make to remember the father, the more Maya will try to make you fall. Your stage should be so strong that no storms of Maya can shake you. Ravan is not anything else, nor is it a human being. Ravan, the five vices, is called Maya. The devilish community of Ravan doesn't recognize who you are. What do these BKs explain? No one understands this in reality. Why are you called BKs? Whose child is Brahma? You children know that you now have to return home. The father sits here and gives you children these teachings. May you have a long life and may you be wealthy. He fulfills all your desires and gives you blessings. However, nothing will happen just by receiving those blessings. You have to make effort. Everything has to be understood. You have to earn a right to give yourself the tilak of a kingdom. The father gives you this right. He gives you children teachings. Do this and this. The number one teaching that he gives you is constantly remember me alone. People don't remember him, and because they don't know him, their remembrance is wrong. They say that God is omnipresent, so how can they remember, say, Baba? They go to a Shiva temple and worship him. You can say to them, "Tell me his occupation." They would reply that God is omnipresent. They worship him and ask him for mercy. And then when someone asks them where God is, they say that he is omnipresent. Look what they do in front of the images. And when they are not in front of the images, all their virtues are lost. They make so many mistakes on the path of devotion, and yet they still have so much love for devotion. They even stay on a fast and go without water for Sri Krishna. Here you study, whereas look what those devotees do. You are now amused by all of that. According to the drama, while performing devotion, you have continued to move down. No one can climb up. This is the most auspicious confluence age which no one knows about. You are now making effort to become the most elevated beings. Teachers are the servants of the students because they serve them. They are servants of the government. The father says, I too serve you and also teach you. He is the father of all souls. He becomes the teacher. He also tells you the knowledge of the beginning, middle and end of the world. No human being has this knowledge. No one else can teach it. You are making effort to become this. People of the world have such tamopradhan intellects. The world is very fearsome. People do what they shouldn't do. They commit so much violence and robbery, etc. What do they not do? They are 100% tamopradhan, whereas you are now becoming 100% tasatopradhan. You are shown the method of the pilgrimage of remembrance for that. It is only by having remembrance that your sins will be absolved and you will go and meet the Father. You now understand how God the Father comes. He has entered this chariot and speaks this knowledge to you through Brahma. You imbibe this and then relate it to others so that they have the desire to listen to him directly and belong to the Father's family. Here there is the Father, the Mother and also you children. You are all part of this family. That world is devilish. Because you are fed up with the devilish family, you leave your business, etc. and come to Baba to be refreshed. It is Brahmins who reside here. So you come and sit in this family. When you go back home, you won't have such a family. There you become like other bodily beings. You become free from that mundane business and come here. The father now says, renounce all the relationships of bodies and become fragrant flower. A flower has fragrance. Everyone picks flowers and smells them. No one would pick an ak flower. So you have to make effort to become flowers. This is why Baba also brings flowers and tells you, you have to become like these. While living at home, you have to remember the one father. You know that those bodily relations are all to end. Each of you is earning an incognito income here. You have to shed your bodies. You have to earn your income and shed your bodies while remaining cheerful. Stay in remembrance of the Father while walking and touring around and you will never become tired. No matter how much you walk in a bodiless stage in remembrance of the Father, even if you walk from here down to Abu Road, you won't get tired. Your sins will be cut away and you will become light. No one else can know how much you children benefit. People of the whole world are calling out, O purifier, come and purify us. In that case, how can he be called the Mahatma, brackets great soul? You wouldn't bow down to those who are impure. You would only bow down in front of those who are pure. There is the example of a Kumari. When she becomes impure, she has to bow down in front of everyone and call out, O purifier, come. So why did you become impure that you have to call out? Because this is the kingdom of Ravan. Everyone's body is created out of vice. You have now left Ravan. This is called the most auspicious confluence age. You now make effort to go to the kingdom of Rama. The golden age is the kingdom of Rama. If you were to say that just the silver age is the kingdom of Rama, then what happened to the Sun Dynasty kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan? You children are now receiving all of this knowledge. New ones come and you give them this knowledge and make them worthy too. Sometimes they go into such company that from being worthy, they become unworthy. The Father purifies you and so you mustn't become impure anymore. Since the Father has come to purify you, Maya becomes so powerful that she makes you impure and defeats you. You then call out, Baba, protect me. Wonderful. So many people die on a battlefield. So are they protected? These bullets from Maya are even stronger than a bullet from a gun. When you are hurt by the vice of lust, you fall down from the top. In the golden age, all are pure and belong to the pure household religion, and they are called deities. You now know how the father comes, where he resides, and how he teaches you Raja Yoga. They portray him sitting in the chariot of Arjuna and giving knowledge. In that case, why do they call him omnipresent? They have forgotten the father who establishes heaven. He himself is now giving you his introduction. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long-lost and now-found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap, Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children, and the spiritual children say namaste to the spiritual father. Essence for Dharana number 1. In order to become great soul and all dirty habits of impurity, to cause sorrow, to fight and quarrel, and are all dirty acts which you must not perform, earn the right to give yourself the tilak of a kingdom. Second, remove your intellects from all mundane business and bodily beings and become fragrant flowers. In order to earn an incognito income, practice being bodiless while walking and moving around. Blessing, may you be a jewel who has positive thoughts for other by using the power of your pure and positive thoughts, souls. Sorry. Yeah. Oh. Okay, blessing, may you be a jewel who has pure and positive thoughts for others. And by using the power of your own pure and positive thoughts, free souls from worrying. In today's world, all souls are jewels of worry. With the power of your pure and positive thoughts, you jewels who have pure and positive thoughts for others can transform those jewels of worry. Just as the rays of the sun dispel darkness from very far away, in the same way the light and rays in the form of pure and positive thoughts of you jewels spread in all directions of the world. This is why they believe that some spiritual light is doing its work in an incognito way. They have begun to have this touching and are looking for you. Eventually, they will reach this place. Slogan, in order to catch Bab Dada's directions clearly, keep the line of your mind and intellect clear. Slogan, in order to catch Bab Dada's directions clearly, keep the line of your mind and intellect clear. Om Shanti.